Well, I ran into just a little bit of a snag, but it's snags can be fixed. So anyway, this starter drive is just not working right. It's all wore off here on the end, and it won't kick in. And so I went to my little reservoir, not really, but I have some spare parts that I've collected through the years, and I found this little baby, and I thought, I got to looking at it, and I thought, hey, they're not necessarily identical. This is off of a Alice Chalmers, and this is off of a John Deere. In fact, if you can see it, it's painted green. It's got some numbers on it there. I'm going to try to take a picture of that, get them washed off. Now, the good news is, here's the positive tab, and here's the, obviously it's grounded to the frame of the tractor. And when I tried it, just with a 12-volt, just spins like everything and works great. It's even got this little band here at the end, like it does here. And so I'm going to take this part off and put it on here. And then this band, I'll put that band here to cover this up from getting moisture and so forth in it. And when I get it done, and on the tractor, even the, let me see here. Oh yeah, even the hole is in about the same place. Well, maybe it's not exactly the same place, but it's on top. It's on top instead of on the bottom. Or something like that. It's really not in the exact same place, but it's close. This hole here that tightens it, that holds it in. I think it just may work. And I can take this off, put it on here. Doesn't really have to be in that hole anyway, but we'll see. But I think maybe it'll work. And so it pays to keep old parts off of tractors that you've had discard or something, because you might be able to use them. And if it doesn't work, I haven't lost anything. But I've got a feeling it will. So this is a little smaller in diameter than this, so we'll have to see. So I'll let you know more later. This is Gary. We're out of here.